In this video, we'll go over 8 things not to do in Excel. Let's go. First up, we've got error values, and nobody likes to see them, and you certainly don't want to send your boss an Excel file with them inside. So here's a quick fix. And you can download this Excel file we'll be working with in the description. So over here, if we take a closer look, you can see that we're calculating the profit margin, which if you press F2 to look inside it, is simply gonna be the gross profit divided by the revenue here. Now, if we move this along, you can see that over here we start to get an error sign. That's simply because there's nothing that it's being able to divide by. And same thing over here, if I change this net revenue to just delete it, you'll notice that I get the same error sign. So we wanna try to avoid and get rid of that essentially. To do so, first let's press Ctrl Z to go back there. And in here, what we're gonna do is press the F2 key. And at the very front, we're gonna do the if error function. Press the tab key there, and this is saying, well, if there is no error, then we'll just keep it as is, so this fraction is fine with us, comma, and if there is an error, then we're just simply going to put in quotations, let's just put NA, close the quotations, close the brackets, and hit enter there. From here, let's just drag this across, so Control Shift Right all the way to the end, and then press Control R. Great, now you can see over here that it starts to say NA for us. I put NA, but really you can put anything you want in there. It could just be nothing. If you just leave the quotations, that's gonna be nothing for you. Control Shift Right and then Control R. There you go. Next up, we have hidden cells. And this one's pretty serious. In fact, it's so serious that Barclays, a bank, ended up losing money in 2008 as nobody spotted the hidden cells as they became visible only when printed in a PDF, which meant that they ended up buying a lot more contracts than they had in mind and ended up losing money. To show you on Excel, let's say we've got this data set over here with the different regions alongside some figures. And let's suppose that we want to hide this whole EMEA region because we're not quite interested in it for now. So to hide it, we're just going to select the shift space here and then shift down arrow. That's going to select that area for us. Right click, and from there you can go to hide. Now the problem with the hiding is that it's not very clear that something's hidden in here. If you just come into the model for the first time and you see this database, then it's not very obvious that there's something hidden in there unless you're actually looking for it. Let's press Ctrl Z to get out of that. Now the better way to go about this is through grouping. So once you have this area selected, you're just gonna press the Shift Alt and then you're gonna press the right arrow and then press the left arrow to remove that. So the right arrow there, that's gonna group it for us. Then you press that minus sign. And over here, if somebody is new coming into the Excel file, then it's quite obvious that there's this thing over here and they can just press it and see what's going on there. Thirdly, we've got static text, and this one's more of a productivity hack than it is an error. Sometimes it's useful to have the text in a dynamic format. So if you look into the Excel file over here, you can see that we have this Netflix investment analysis. Let's say we use the same template every time for different stocks that we want to analyze. And all we have to do here, if you go under company name, is suppose we change this to Apple, then you'll notice that everything has changed to Apple dynamically. So that's something that we wanna be able to do in the future. Press Ctrl Z to go back there. Now, if you wanna change this, all you have to do is actually link it. If you can see, let me just go ahead and delete this one. And we wanna link that cell over here and then add shareholders to the end. So we'll just go equals, then we're gonna link this cell over here. We're gonna press the ampersand. And then in quotations, we're gonna put a space first. So there's a bit of spacing there. And we'll just type shareholders, close those quotations and hit enter. Now you see it says Netflix shareholders. If I change this to HBO, then all of a sudden, all of that is going to change as well. So that's basically the idea here. So having text like this, especially in templates, is going to save you a lot of time. More importantly, it's going to minimize the chances of you making an error somewhere. Next up, in number 4, we've got hardcoding numbers inside a formula, and I'm definitely guilty of this one in the past. So over here, if you look at the Excel file, you can see that we've got an income statement, and we have a few assumptions below that are basically making up the income statement. So if you look under the gross revenue, let's say we go on this one over here, you can see that the formula is saying it's gonna be the previous year's gross revenue times 1 plus a growth rate. Now, that growth rate is linking over here to the gross revenue growth, but the problem is that this one's actually not dynamic. Instead, you just type the number in here, and this is what is meant by it's hard-coded, meaning that it's not linked to anything. And so over here, if I go ahead and change this revenue growth to say something like a 5%, everything is gonna change over here. However, up top, nothing is changing, and the reason for that is because it's hard-coded. So we need to go ahead and change that. Now, luckily, this has a bit of an easy fix. So we'll just press the F2 key. From here, let's go ahead and delete this area. And we're just gonna link it down over here. hit enter there, and from here we can just shift, control shift right arrow all the way to the end, press control R, that's gonna drag the whole formula all the way across. If you go over to the very last one, press the F2 key, you can see that now it's dynamically linking. So if I were to change this revenue growth to say something like 5%, then you'll notice that everything else is gonna change, not just down over here, but also on the revenue figures above. And if you're watching these tips and tricks and wondering how you can apply them to the real world, Financial Edge provides certified online finance courses, and they're also sponsoring this video. They're the instructors that teach the new hires at the top 4 investment banks across the globe, so you can get the exact same training online at your own pace. Their best-selling investment banker course goes over all the relevant skills to succeed in an analyst role. These include financial accounting, financial modeling on Excel, valuation, and more. And if you're interested in other areas of finance, they've also got courses on private equity, trading, and portfolio management, where you can learn all aspects of the investment management industry. So if you're interested in checking them out, you can go to a link in the description below and get 25% off using code KENJI25. Alright, so we're past halfway in things not to do in Excel, and now we've got merge and center. Now it's fine if you merge and center something like the title within a specific Excel file, but you really don't want to be merging and centering specific rows within the dataset. To show you an example, over here you can see that you've got all of these different regions with their store count, etc. And you'll notice that all of these are merged and centered, as you can see up over here. So you can see the Europe one, the Asia one, etc. Now suppose that we've got all these revenue figures and we want to find out what's the average revenue of all of these. So we'll go equals, average, press the tab key there. We're just going to go ahead and select all of these. So we'll keep going up, but you'll notice that this starts to open up all the way to the edge. You can't really take it back anymore. Now the reason for that is because this whole area is merged and centered. So first, let's go ahead and undo that by just clicking on merge and center once. What you can do instead, firstly, let's delete this one. What you can do instead is select that area that you're interested in, where you want it to be centered, by pressing the shift right. From here, you're gonna go down to this toggle over here. If you can't find it, just press the control 1 key. And under the alignment tab for horizontal, we're gonna go right into the center across the selection. Hit OK there. Now you'll have the same effect, but the only difference is gonna be that it's not its own cell, instead it's on multiple cells, which is a lot nicer there. So now you can easily go do the average and it's gonna take you up way above that with no problem there. Next up in number 6, we've got forgetting to protect cells. And one of the easiest ways to do that is using data validation. So let's look into that. Over here, suppose we have this data set with the high net worth individual list. So people that are above a 10 million net worth, as you can see over here. And suppose by mistake, we put somebody with a lower net worth than that, like let's say just $500, then obviously that shouldn't be on this list and that would be an error for us. Now, in order to protect that, to prevent that from happening, you can do a few different things. Let's delete that first. We're just gonna select this whole area over here, so all the relevant list for us, which is gonna be down all the way till the bottom. From here, we're gonna go under data. Then you're gonna click on this part over here where it has the check sign. From here, we're gonna go, we wanna allow only people that have a net worth higher than the 10 million there. So we're just gonna go for a whole number. Instead of between, we want it to be, say, greater than or equal to. That minimum for us is gonna be 10 million. And now let's also put an error alert. So basically when this is wrong, when somebody is not inputting that, we should let them know what's going on exactly. So let's say as a title, we put something like not above 10M. And then as the error message, you can actually describe it in more detail. For now, I'm just gonna put hello there, just so you can see what it's like. Hit okay. And from here, suppose this next person, Naila, it actually has a net worth of $500. Then it's gonna say not above 10 million, and it's gonna tell you why here. I just put hello for now though. So that's a quick and easy way to protect your data from having the wrong values. Similar to that, in point 7, we've got protecting entire sheets. Now, a reason you may want to do this is suppose you're sending a complex model to somebody else, and you don't really want them to actually be touching the formulas and seeing what could be changed there. In this scenario, suppose we've got an income statement like this one over here, forecasted into the future, so quite a complex model in which we have different assumptions that base the model. Over here, you can see that we've got revenue assumptions for a best case, so a very optimistic scenario, a base, which would be a, just an average scenario, and the worst case if some things really went bad. If you go all the way to the top here, under a choose scenario, you can see that you can actually go ahead and change these from the best case to the base case and see how all the figures would change. Suppose I go to the best case, now you can see that all the revenues seem to be a lot higher and everything else looks a lot better as well. Now, to be able to only protect this area over here, so to make sure that nobody can come in, say put a zero here and end up breaking the model. Now for this, you can go ahead, firstly, we're gonna have to click on this one, go to right click, go to format cells, because this one we still want as editable so people can see what it's gonna be like based on a base case, a best case, or a worst case scenario. Untick on that locked under the protection area, hit OK there, and then down over here, we're gonna want to protect everything else. So we're just gonna go to review, go to protect sheet, hit OK there, don't worry about what it says over here. And now what we have is this area that's fully dynamic, so we can change. And then everything down below, if I change this to a zero, then it's not gonna let me, it's gonna give us this pop-up, which is exactly the way we want it. So everyone is still able to see what would happen under the different scenarios, but they're not able to switch things up. And lastly, we've got filtering, and I'm not gonna say not to filter, but instead just be careful with it. So let me show you an example. If you go over to the very last tab, you'll notice that you have all of this data set over here. Press Ctrl A to select it. Let's just go to Sort and Filter under the Home tab. From here, we're just gonna click on Filter. And let's suppose that we wanna get rid of all of the APAC ones because we're not really counting them. So we're just gonna go in here, click on that dropdown, and we're just gonna deselect the APAC. Hit OK there. And now let's say that we wanna count all of these revenues over here. We're just gonna select them, Control C, and suppose we need them for something else. So we're just gonna paste them over here to the side, Control V. Now you'll notice that it's actually not pasting all of them, or that's what it appears like. And the problem here lies in these rows that are actually not showing right now. And so the paste has actually gone inside all of the APAC region, which you currently can't see. If I go and unfilter this, so clear filters from region, you'll notice that it's actually in there. But the problem is that it's copied kind of to the wrong area. So it seems like all of these revenues here are for APAC when in fact they're for EMEA. Now, a quick and dirty way to fix this is simply to paste them somewhere where the rows aren't hidden. So let's go back to the region here. Let's deselect the APAC, hit OK. And now let's say I want this data set over here again. I want these revenues for Americas and EMEA only. I'll press Control C. And if I paste them down below, it's not gonna have a problem. It's gonna be able to paste all of them. The problem here is with these ones that you can't actually see the rows 8 to 13. That's why you get this over here, which looks like an error. Let me know down in the comments if you made any of these Excel errors yourself, and no shame about it, I've made many of them myself. If you wanna learn more about Excel formulas, check out this link over here, or this other link over here if you wanna check out our Excel course. Hit that like and that subscribe button if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.